Welcome students, the next part of this interference is interference in thin film. So first we will see what is thin film. Thin film is an optical medium, means that should allow the light to pass through it, and whose thickness is said to be 0.5 micrometer to 10 micrometer. If the thickness of the film is said to be of this much, that is 0.5 micrometer to 10 micrometer, then that is considered as thin film. A transparent thin film of uniform thickness bounded by two parallel surfaces. Look at this diagram. This is the transparent very thin film, thickness is very small, and this is bounded by two parallel surfaces, and this is known as plane parallel thin film. So now look at this. A light is incident on the first surface of the thin film. So light is incident on the first surface of the thin film, and when light hits this, what happens is part of the light ray is reflected and part of the light ray is transmitted into the thin film. So now in this case, in the case of thin film, most of the light ray is transmitted and very small portion is reflected. Then again this transmitted ray, this hits the second surface of the thin film. Then again what happens at the second surface, part of this, for the second surface, this will be the incident ray, part of this will be reflected and part of this will be transmitted after the second surface. So here this reflected ray, which is coming from the second surface, then again this is going to hit the first surface. Then at the first surface what happens, part of this incident ray, for the first surface this becomes incident ray, part of this will be reflected and part of this will be transmitted above the first surface of the thin film. So now in this case, thin film transmits incident ray very strongly. Here for the first surface this is transmitted ray, and for the second surface here will be the transmitted ray. This thin film transmits this rays strongly and reflect only weakly. This reflected ray, that will be weak. After two reflections, the intensity of the reflected rays is dropping. That's why only first two rays we are going to consider, because this phenomenon is there, this reflection, transmission, then again at the first surface reflection, transmission, second surface reflection, transmission, this process continues. But here only two reflected rays we are going to consider, because the intensity is only little bit high for the first and the second rays, and the remaining waves coming from the multiple reflections, that we are going to neglect. So now here this first reflected ray, this appears to come from point S1, and the second reflected ray, this appears to come from the point S2. So now this S1 and S2 are the two coherent sources which are derived from the single source. From the single ray we have got these two, S1 and S2. These two rays we are going to get by the single ray. From the single ray, because of this multiple reflection and refraction phenomena, the ray, reflected ray 1 and 2 are derived, and these 1 and 2 appears to come from S1 and S2. Now S1 and S2, these two acts as the coherent sources. So now what happens, these two reflected rays, the two reflected rays, they travel along the parallel path and they are going to interfere, they are going to meet at infinity, because these two are parallel rays. So now in the upcoming derivation we will derive what is the condition for the maxima and minima. That can be deduced once we have calculated the optical path difference between the two rays at the point of their meeting. So look at the second diagram. Here we are going to derive the condition for the maxima and minima at the point of interference, where the rays are going to interfere in the thin film. So that is due to the reflected light. Interference due to reflected light in the thin film. For that you consider a thin film. So this is the thin film whose thickness is T. T is the thickness of this film. Let mu be the refractive index of this thin film. So now consider the incident light AB. So this is the incident light AB. This hits the first surface of the thin film. Then what happens? Part of this incident ray is reflected in this direction and part of this is transmitted. Here the reflected light is less as compared to this transmitted ray, because in this case the most of the ray is transmitted. So now for this incident ray, at the point of incidence, if we draw the normal, if we draw the perpendicular, so this, the angle of incident ray with the normal, that we call as angle of incidence. So this is the normal drawn at the point of incidence. So angle between this incident ray and the normal, that is I, angle of incidence. Now this is the refracted ray. This is refracted ray, or you can call this as transmitted ray. This is the normal. Then the angle between normal and the refracted ray, that is R. We can call this as angle of refraction. Now for the first surface, this will be the reflected ray. This is reflected ray, and the angle between normal and the reflected ray will be, because if this angle, according to the law of reflection, if this angle is I and this angle also will be with respect to the normal, this also will be I, both the angle of incidence and the angle of reflection will be same. So if this is I, means this also will be equal to I. So now what happens? This transmitted ray, this travels inside the thin film and it hits the second layer of the thin film. Then again at the second layer of the thin film, part of this transmitted ray is reflected and part of this is transmitted in this direction. So now if you draw the normal at the point of incidence at the second surface, this will be the normal drawn. Then the angle between this normal and this refracted ray will be R. This angle becomes R. Why? Because if this angle is R, if this is R, then automatically this also will be equal to R, because according to the law of geometry, this is R, this also will be R. Then for the second surface, this will be the reflected ray. According to the law of reflection, the angle of incidence will be equal to angle of reflection. So if this is R, means automatically this also will be equal to R. So now what happens? This reflected ray, this hits the first surface of the thin film. Part of the ray will be reflected and part of the ray will be transmitted. So here this will be the transmitted ray and here will be the reflected ray. Don't bother about that. And this phenomenon considered, and this phenomenon, so that goes. But here only first two reflected rays from the first surface we are going to consider. So this is ray 1 and this is ray 2. If these two reflected rays are made to interfere by using some converging lens, then the both the rays are going to converge and they produce the interference pattern. Now these two rays are derived from the single ray, that is from the single source, so that which can produce the interference effectively. Now in order to find the condition for the maxima and the minima at the point of meeting, so we have to find out optical path difference and the geometrical path difference. So in order to find that, look at these two rays, ray 1 and ray 2. After the point H and D, both the rays travel the same distance. But here is some path difference. One ray is traveling extra distance than the second ray. Ray 1 is traveling extra distance than the second ray. So now in order to find this extra distance that the first ray traveling, I will draw a normal from the point D. This is the point D. From the point D, I will draw the normal. So which cuts the ray 1 at the point H. Now this BH is the extra path that the first ray is traveling. So in order to find all these things, so look at the geometry. This, since this is the normal drawn for the first ray, this angle will be 90. So now look at this angle BH. So BH is, see, this is the normal and this is the first layer of the thin film. If this angle is I, automatically this becomes equal to 90 minus I, because this is right angle. If this is I, means the remaining part will be 90 minus I, and this is the normal drawn, so obviously this angle is also 90. If this is 90, this is 90 minus I, this angle automatically becomes equal to I, this angle becomes equal to I. So now we'll see what is the geometrical path difference between ray 1 and ray 2. So geometrical path length is simply the physical distance that the light travels, how much physical distance that the light travels. And what is optical path length is? Optical path length is the distance the light travels times the refractive index. For example, if light is traveling through 10 centimeter of water, if light is traveling through 10 centimeter of water, then the optical path length becomes equal to 10 times refractive index. That is, refractive index of the water is 1.33, 10 times 1.33, which becomes equal to 13.3 centimeter is the optical path length. And the geometrical path length is that much distance only, how much the physical distance that the light travels. So now, from the geometry of the figure, what I can write is, from the triangle BGF, this is the right angle triangle, from this cos R is equal to what I can write, this is the R, angle R, from this cos R is equal to what I can write, cos R is GF, adjacent side, divided by hypotenuse. Hypotenuse is this BF. So this GF is nothing but, GF is nothing but the thickness of the thin film, that I can write as T, divided by BF will be there. Then from this, what I can write, this BF is equal to what I can write, T divided by cos R. Just rearrangement is there. I will send this BF here, and GF is nothing but the T divided by cos R it becomes. Then from the same triangle, BG is equal to what I can write, BG is equal to this length. For this angle, this becomes opposite side. So tan R is equal to what I can write, tan R is equal to BG divided by T. So this is opposite divided by adjacent side. So this is opposite and this is the adjacent side. So that I can write as BG divided by T I can write. So from that, BG is equal to T into tan R I can write. So now, this DH is the normal drawn to the ray BC. From the points H and D, from the point H and D onwards, the ray 1 and ray 2, these two travel the same path. The ray BH, this travels in air, while the ray BD, this BD means BF to FD, BF to FD, that is ray BD, this travels in the film of refractive index mu. This BH travels in air medium, and this ray BD, this travels in the film of refractive index mu along the path BF and FD. Now, from this geometrical path difference between the two rays, geometrical path difference, only how much path difference is there between the two rays, this we can write as BF plus FD minus BH we can write. After the point H and D, both the rays travel the same distance. Here the geometrical path difference, how much extra distance the rays are traveling. The second ray is traveling extra distance BF to FD. Then again, the first ray is traveling extra distance, how much? This BH. Then geometrical path difference. Path difference between the ray 1 and ray 2 we can write as this BF plus FD, since this is the largest distance, minus this BH, that gives the geometrical path difference between the two rays. Because after the points H and D, these two are going to travel the same distance. But before this, Ray 2 is traveling extra distance. How much? This is BF to FD. And ray 1 is traveling extra distance. This BH. That's why path difference between the two rays, and that path difference is geometrical path difference. That is BF FD minus this BH we can write. Then from the same figure, optical path difference is equal to. Optical path difference, what we can write? So here the geometrical path into the refractive index, that becomes optical path length. So from this, what we can write is this BF FD, the ray BF FD, this is traveling inside the medium of refractive index mu. So this we can write as mu times this BF plus FD minus this BH is there, this is traveling in the air medium whose refractive index is considered to be 1. So here the refractive index of the air is considered to be 1. Now the difference between these two with respect to the refractive index, this we call as optical path difference. So now from the geometry, we are going to find the values of this BF, FD and BH, and we'll substitute in this formula, that is optical path difference. So this optical path difference, this we are going to represent by this delta A. Delta A we can simply write as mu times the geometrical path length. So geometrical path length is this, and this we can write as mu of this geometrical path length is this BF plus FD minus this BH into 1. So now in the triangle, from the triangle BFD, this angle BFG is equal to, this angle BFG is equal to angle GFD, and both are nothing but R, and this distance BF, that is equal to FD, this BF is equal to FD. So now from this, what I can write as BF is equal to, already we know the value of this BF. BF is equal to T divided by cos R. You call this optical path difference equation as 1. This is equation 1. And now this BF is equal to T by cos R is there. Now BF plus FD is equal to, what we can write? BF plus FD. This BF plus FD, this is equal to, if BF is T by cos R, then the GD will be also equal to T by cos R, because both the angles are same. This angle BFG is also R, angle GFD is also R. Then if this BF is equal to T by cos R, then the FD also will be equal to T by cos R. So the sum of BF plus FD, this we can write as 2T by cos R. 2T by cos R. Now you call this as equation 2. So now from the geometry, BG is equal to GD. This BG is equal to GD we can write. And BD is equal to, what we can write is 2 times BG. From the geometry of the figure, BG is equal to GD we can write. And BD is equal to, what we can write? This total distance BD is equal to 2 times BG. So now BG, already we know the value of this BG. BG is equal to this T times tan R. BG is equal to T tan R. So therefore BD is equal to, what I can write? BD is equal to 2 times BG is there. 2 times T tan R we can write. Now already I explained the angle HBD. The angle HBD is 90 minus I. Here what we can write? Angle HBD is equal to, what we can write? 90 minus I. And the angle BHD is, angle BHD is 90, because this is the normal drawn. And the angle BDH is I. So this obviously becomes equal to I, because this is the triangle, the sum of all the angles should be equal to 180 degree. So in order to make this 180 degree means this always should be equal to I. Now from this what we can write is BH is equal to, what we can write, this BH is equal to for this angle I, this BH is the opposite side. From this what we can write, sin I is equal to this opposite, we can write sin I is equal to BH divided by BD, we can write BH by BD. Sin I is equal to BH divided by this BD. So from that only what I am going to write is BH is equal to BD into sin I will write. So already you know the value of this BD. BD is equal to 2T tan R into this sin I. Now from the Snell's law, we know that sin I by sin R is equal to the ratio of sin of angle of incidence to the sin of angle of refraction, that is equal to mu, that gives the refractive index. So this, if you substitute the value of this sin I in place of sin I, if you write mu into sin R, this becomes equal to BH becomes equal to 2T tan R into sin I is mu times sin R. From this what you can write, 2 mu T tan R into sin R, which you can also write as 2 mu T tan R, you can write as sin R by cos R. So sin R into sin R, that becomes equal to sin square R divided by cos R. So now by substituting all these terms in equation 1, BH, BF and FD, if you substitute all these terms in equation 1, what we are going to get is this optical path difference is equal to mu times 2T BF plus FD, that is 2T cos R, this is 2T divided by cos R, minus BH is 2 mu T sin square R divided by this cos R. And if we simplify this, if you take the common terms outside, 2 mu T divided by cos R is common from both the terms. So what is left is 1 minus sin square R is left. So 1 minus sin square R we can write as cos square R. So this becomes equal to 2 mu T by cos R into this cos square R. So this becomes equal to 1 cos get cancels out. You are left with 2 mu T into cos R. So this is the optical path difference between the two reflected rays, and these two reflected rays we have got from the single ray. So these two reflected rays are made to interfere with the help of convex lens, and we can get the interference pattern. This derivation we have got by considering the geometry, means by considering light as the ray, but actually in the interference light behaves as the wave. If light behaves as the wave, in the Stokes law already I have told, there will be phase change occurs when there is the reflection from the denser medium, when there is the reflection from the rarer medium. Already this I have discussed in the Stokes law. So what it says is, when a ray is reflected at the boundary of rarer to denser medium, if the light is reflected from the denser medium, then there is the path change of lambda by 2. If the light is reflected from denser medium, then path change of lambda by 2 occurs. So this we can explain with the help of this. See, for this case, for the first reflected ray, this BC, the light is reflected from the denser medium. If this is the case. If light is reflected from the denser medium, then there will be phase change of pi. Means how we can explain is, if crest is reaching at this point, then this reflected ray, this starts from the trough, means there is phase change of pi. So this is what means lambda by 2 half. So this is what happens when the light is reflected from the denser medium. If the light is reflected here, this is the case. If this is the case for the second ray, see here at the point D, the light is traveling from denser to rarer medium. If this is the case, then at this point no phase change. Then between the ray 1 and ray 2, some correction factor is to be added. Here no phase change, but here the phase change takes place. Now in the optical path difference, some correction factor is to be added, and that is lambda by 2. Phase pi means the wavelength, that is lambda by 2. If you consider this as the wave, this is one complete wave. This distance we call as one wave. This is one wave, that is what we call as wavelength. Half of this is nothing but lambda by 2. In terms of phase, this will be 2 pi. So here this becomes equal to pi. Phase change of pi occurs means in terms of path, this will be lambda by 2. So now in this expression of optical path difference, so this correction factor is to be added, that is 2 mu t cos r minus this lambda by 2. This is to be added. So now this is the actual optical path difference between the two reflected rays. So now in the next class, we'll study condition for the maxima and minimum, and then we'll go ahead. So now take the assignment question, students. First question is, explain Fresnel's biprism experimental setup along with the theory. Second question, explain Stokes treatment. Third one, explain interference in thin films due to reflected light. Diagrams what you are drawing for all these should be neat and labeled, and the ray diagram is must. So write the answer for all these questions and you upload in the classroom app. Thank you.